Hither came Conan, the Cimmerian, black-haired, sullen-eyed, sword in hand, a thief, a reaver, a slayer. With gigantic melancholies and gigantic mirth, to tread the jeweled thrones of the earth under his sandaled feet. That's a quote from the Nemedian Chronicles. If you don't know the connections between Conan and Lovecraft, this video might be perfect for you. Before we begin though, let me thank you for watching JLS Comics and pressing play. If you enjoy videos like this, don't forget to hit the like button and share the video with your friends, and if you already haven't, the subscribe button as well. I upload new comic book and superhero content weekly. Alright, with that out of the way, let's jump into our Conan story. Conan the Barbarian, Conan the Reaver, Conan the Cimmerian, Conan the Champion, Conan the Adventurer, the Usurper, the Destroyer, King Conan, Conan the Liberator. He's gone by many titles during his 80 plus years of literary life. He also happens to be Atlantean Jason Momoa and Californian Arnold Schwarzenegger, and the Germanic Rolf Müller. The Hyborian Age is an age undreamed of, a time before the modern age and before the historical record was kept. It was an age after the fall of Atlantis and during the proto-Indus rise of civilization. It is here in this ancient time when the stories of Conan take place. Hyperborea in Greek mythology is a land to the north. Hyboria borrows its name from the Greeks. Hyperborea literally means beyond the north wind. In Hyboria, there was a kingdom called Cimmeria, borrowed from the Cimmeria from Homer's The Odyssey. Howard Cimmeria is nestled to the north of Aquilonia and south of Asgard that bore the future king. It's a land that would be near Scotland and Ireland, making the Cimmerians a somewhat proto-Gaelic society. Conan believes in the god Crom, an ancient deity whose name Howard adapted from the Celtics. However, Crom is only invoked in curses. Crom brings death and trouble, but imbues his believers with power at birth. The Cimmerians were descendants of Atlanteans, and upon contact with other kingdoms of Hyboria, slowly began to civilize their clans and adopt technology. The Thurian Age, the time of King Cole, ended with the Great Cataclysm sometime around 40,000 BC and gave rise to the Hyborian Age and the Age of Conan. By this time, Howard had already garnered respect from his readers and peers for stories like those Cole stories and the Shadow Kingdom. Robert E. Howard's very first tale of Conan came at a time in the late 1920s, early 1930s, when pulp fiction was immensely popular and Howard's own creation, Cole, had seen his own level of success. Howard would submit his stories to a pulp magazine called Strange Tales. One such story, By This Axe I Rule, was rejected by the magazine. Howard reworked it using Conan instead of Cole and resubmitted it with a new title, The Phoenix on the Sword. He had a circle of literary friends, notably H.P. Lovecraft, and there were many connections and loose alliterations and allegories and subtle inferences to each other's stories and in each other's works. For example, Howard's old ones from 1934's Queen of the Black Coast could be the same nameless old ones from Lovecraftian lore. The Hyborian Age is an age full of monsters and dread, inspired by the influential Lovecraft. This makes Conan obliquely related to the Cthulhu mythos. It's an adjunct and draws inspiration from there. Conan himself, son of the Hyborian blacksmith Corin and his wife Greshen, was born into war, birthed on a bloody battlefield. Conan thirsted for combat, for blood, and for the respect of formidable warrior demands. Conan's travels frequently brought him into direct conflict with witches and wizards and nameless, shapeless, horrific monsters. Conan, though, also frequently came in contact with princes and damsels that he, ever chivalrous, would without hesitation want to help. He knew Bellet and Valeria, and at Marvel, Conan met and frequently teamed up with Red Sonja with a J, a character that Roy Thomas pulled from Howard's Red Sonja with a Y of Rogatino. Though friend of Conan, Red Sonja hails from Hyrcania, not Hyboria. Conan did appear in the 1985 Red Sonja movie, but due to the rights being held by Universal, who made the first two Conan films, and not famous films makers of Red Sonja, Dino De Laurentiis made Arnold a Conan analog called Lord Kalidor. Sadly, after scribing dozens of Conan sagas like the classic Tower of the Elephant, The Frost Giant's Daughter, Queen of the Black Coast, Robert E. Howard committed suicide in 1936. Copyrights passed through hands such as Lancer, whose novels were on boys' nightstands all through the decade, those Frank Fazetta covers proudly displayed, eventually landing in the hands of Marvel Comics in the 1970s. This was the dawn of the Bronze Age of comic books, a time when the changing social climate focused on darker, heavier themes, and it was 2 short months after Conan's debut issue that the Comic Code Authority made their first revisions to the code, and just a few months before Stan Lee's famous drug issues in Amazing Spider-Man. According to Roy Thomas, fans were writing in requesting sword and sorcery, wanting Howard or Tolkien or Burroughs adaptations, so Thomas wrote up a letter to Marvel's publisher Martin Goodman to make a bid for the license to publishing rights. In Chamber of Darkness, number 4, Thomas and Winsor Smith crafted the tale of Star the Slayer, which many consider the testbed for the upcoming Conan book. But before Conan, Thomas, $150 in hand for the license, sought out Thongor. Roy Thomas said this about that time, Stan and I had figured that Conan, who after all was in a number of popular paperbacks by now, would undoubtedly be out of our league financially. Lynn himself liked comments and liked the idea of Thongor being a Marvel hero. But negotiations, fell through. With increasing pressure from fans and from Goodman himself, Thomas offered the Howard estate $200 per issue despite only having the $150 authorized by Goodman to be able to use Conan, and guess what? They accepted. Luckily, the title and its spinoffs would go on to great success, pushing over 200,000 copies per issue that more than made up for the $50 difference. Roy Thomas and Barry Windsor Smith were the first creative team to tackle the Barbarian, the same team that wrote Star of the Slayer. Its popularity grew, and 4 years later, Marvel debuted a black and white magazine called Savage Sword of Conan. In 2003, Dark Horse acquired the license to publish Conan books and tasked Kurt Busiek with writing duties and put Kerry Nord on art for the book, simply titled Conan. Dark Horse stuck to Howard's work for 15 years, not to anything that Marvel had published in their 26 years. There was a series of miniseries up until 2019 when Marvel Comics once again acquired the license and started up a new volume of Conan the Barbarian comic books, having successfully renegotiated with the license holder, Conan Properties International. Red Sonja's rights split off and are held by Red Sonja LLC, which is why Dynamite Entertainment was able to publish volumes with her. The 1982 film starring Arnold Schwarzenegger in the titular role was written by John Milius and Oliver Stone in its final treatment. The second in 1984 was written by Roy Thomas, who we were just talking about, same writer on the Marvel comics, along with Jerry Conway. Though not entirely accurate, that first Conan movie does remain the most faithful cinematic adaptation to date. Marvel Comics portrays him as a massively muscled, loincloth-wearing barbarian, in other words, sort of a dimwit. In truth, Howard's Conan is a fully fleshed-out, dynamic, ever-evolving, and multidimensional character with a range of emotions, and always the thieving philanderer and with questionable morals by today's standards, was someone who adapted and grew greatly through his various stories. He's a great character with a lush history and lives in a world with a deep, rich, highly developed lore and mythos. I highly recommend you check out his works and read up on Conan if you haven't. So that, my friends, is Conan. Did I miss something you feel is important? Have questions or an idea for a future history video? Let me know in the comments or tweet me at ComicsJLS and I'll add it to the list. As always, thanks for watching, subscribing, and I will see you in the next video.